What is the potential of the biogas market in India?
Well, biogas is really taking off at the moment in India, as it has happened with solar and wind as well. I mean, the present government and the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy is very bullish about it here. And normally when you talk about biogas in India, we talk about the small scale biogas plant, which consists of many household and community level. And then comes the mid-sized biogas plant and then the industrial size. Yeah. So when you talk about the present situation of the biogas plant in India, the mid-size has already and the small size. Altogether, we already have 4.9 million such biogas plant, but these are very small one and a little community one as well. And for the large-scale biogas plant, we already have around 300 megawatt of installed capacity. But you have to imagine this also consists of the biogas plant, which is installed in, let's say, distillery. It's based on the spent wash or in starch industry likewise. But as far as the multiple feedstock is concerned, we are really looking for the different feed chemistry. So be it cattle manure, which is already the case, but along with this, we are also exploring chicken manure or poultry litter. Along with that, energy crops like Napier grass or elephant grass, because in India we have this food versus fuel thing, and we really want to be the balance from this side. But apart from all this, we are also exploring press mud here. We already have some large plants based on the press mud, and not only that, even as far as the research is concerned, we are exploring some like wheat straw, rice straw, because rice straw burning is one of the vibrant thing right now in India, and we need a solution, a proper solution. And this lignocellulosic biomass definitely brings a lot of research attraction, and once it happens, definitely we can explore further possibilities as far as the biogas market is concerned. So for sure, the biogas market at present in India is attracting a lot of international players as well, and not only the national. And we see a lot of potential. The only question is how to harness this potential from technical angle, from financial angle, and from policy or social engineering angle. Yeah. But what we see in India right now, we are getting a lot of motivation, a lot of promotion also from the government side. So incentive, normally when you talk about, it's from the CapEx subsidy, but what we are also getting in India is the tax holidays. Let's say if you have a megawatt biogas plant, you have 10 years of tax holidays. So it's not only the subsidy, which is the direct subsidy, but also the promotion, which is indirect promotion, you can say, or indirect benefits which you get. And apart from this, we also have a special feed-in tariff. Of course, like in other countries, we do have this feed-in tariff as a state subject here. We do have a regulation from CERC, Central Electricity Regulatory Commission, but the state has to really take care of that here. So states like Punjab, Gujarat, Rajasthan, they are really taking it further like anything as far as the feed-in tariff of biomass or biogas is concerned. But apart from this, the whole ecosystem is being developed and being taken forward between the central and the state as well, as far as the biogas is concerned, in fact.
Can you explain the feed-in tariff in details, please?
So CERC has already defined the feed-in tariff of biomass or biogas in general. It comes to be INR 7.68. That is almost like 10 euro cents actually. Yeah. But the state can even take care of this or give lesser feed-in tariff than this. But that's a normal benchmark.